Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. You can do it better than that. Hallelujah. All right. Are you excited to be here tonight? I don't know, but I am also very, very excited to be here. Because for those who are not so young, a father has come home. Hallelujah. If you are here and you are wondering why people are excited, it shows when you were born. Hallelujah. But we are blessed tonight, and we are blessed for the next 3 nights. Hallelujah. To have a seasoned man of God in the house. Hallelujah. Somebody who pastored this very church 23 or so years ago. You are holding your head. Yeah. That is why you are lost. And it's good to, I'm sure he has a very nice feeling as he has come back after so many years to see some familiar faces who are still around, still serving the Lord. And to even discover that some of them have children who are now teenagers. Hallelujah. Now, this is the man of God that I have admired for a while. You know, when we were young students coming up, these were the men of God. Hallelujah. And it's a blessing to have him here for the next 3 nights. He is currently the convener of the mega church. You now, when you hear the name of the church, you realize that, yeah, it is a church. The mega church, Asori Kessie, Osir Chrome, Asori for Abba in crime. Mankakia, any invitation, my yen yen, the semi kaki, me kiki, because me assure, sir, Osir Chrome for no omu or Facebook, so omu sharing. It has said me to make a kick, a crack. Hallelujah. Oh, but it's a wonderful blessing to have Bishop Eddie Fabian to be with us for the convention. Hallelujah. And he didn't come alone. He came with his wife, Lady Pastor. Somebody was saying, when she arrived, somebody said, original Mama Caro has come. All the other Mama Caros in the church, they are duplicate and triplicate and fake. So please, if you call yourself Mama Caro for these 3 days, find another name. Because original Mama Caro has come. So he's here with his wife. He's here with one of his daughters, Chrisma, who ministered powerfully. You know, that is also a grace, to have your daughter minister before you preach. That one too is also a grace. Reverend David, one day may your daughter minister before you preach. Anyway, so I don't think I have to say much, because daddy has come home. So why don't you stand to your feet, put your hands together, as we welcome Bishop Eddie Ferber.
The glory of the Lord is coming down. The glory
of the Lord.
The glory of the Lord is coming down.
The glory of the Lord.
The glory.
Memories, and I'm very, very happy and excited. I have been here, I think, for a convention how many years ago? We all don't remember. But like Bishop Juice said, we used to pastor the church many years ago. I think we pastored from 98 to when we used to meet in the classroom. Yeah. And I think we left in 2003. And it's been a beautiful journey. We left, actually, we were on our way to Malawi. And then from Malawi, it changed to Cape Coast. I tell you. And then from Cape Coast, it came to Kolegono. And then we stayed in Kolegono for some time, and then to the Kodesh. And then from the Kodesh to Lagos. And then from Lagos to Sierra Leone. And then from Sierra Leone to Obuasi. And then from Obuasi to Kumasi. Hallelujah. Oh, put your hands together for Jesus. But all in all, the Lord has been faithful. The Lord has been faithful. And we thank God. The Lord has blessed us with two lovely girls. The first one, those of you who were here know her, but now she's a big girl. She's now doing her national service after university. Yeah. And so Chrisma just sang, she's in the sixth form, getting ready to go to university. Yeah. Hallelujah. But I'm glad that my beautiful wife is here before I continue. I wanted to say hello to the church. I'm sure she's also having memories and mixed feelings. Right.
Hallelujah. I don't know what to say. But I am very happy to be here. And you know, when Bishop was saying some of you, your children will be here to come and sing as you come and preach, it made me remember so many things which Bishop Dark prophesied. Bishop also prophesied over us. He said, here there will be cars. He said, your children will be this, and I'm seeing them. And I'm seeing people who messed up our wedding songs and everything. I will forgive them. They should own up. Okay. And they have all become something else. All I have to say is that I want to encourage you. Those of you who are giving up, God has something for you. Amen.
Please put your hands together for her. Please show some love. Wow. It's a blessing. It's a blessing. And like my wife said, we've received all these prophecies over our lives for many years. Bishop Dag has been prophesying over us and speaking very great things. I remember when we used to go for Miracle Wave conventions, and Abeka Church will be featuring, and Bishop Dag will say, where's the Abeka Church? They should come and sing. And you reminded me of our wedding. Something went wrong that day, but all things work together for good. Hallelujah. But we thank God to see all of you, to see Gabriel. Gabriel is, yeah. Amen. To see Bradan also. Been here for years, I tell you. So the names have escaped me, but I remember the faces very well. A pastor from, used to be in Santa Maria. Are you still there? No. Wow. So Pastor Ben is here, and Pastor Kwame also. All of them used to be shepherds in the church. And by the grace of God, they are all pastors married with children. Hey, it's amazing. It's amazing. But I want to say God bless all of you. God bless all of you for being faithful. There's always a blessing for faithfulness. And I know that God is going to reward you mightily. And one day you will also be standing somewhere and saying that we used to be here many years ago. And look what the Lord has done. Hallelujah. Put your hands together. Amen. But I want to really salute the angel of the house, Bishop Jude Oraka Tete. Hallelujah. And for those of you who don't know, we were all in the same school together. We went to St. Augustine's College. It's the best school. The best school. Now, we have the microphone, so if we say it's the best school, it's the best school. Yes. You may not agree, but we don't care. We don't care. We have the microphone, so... Yes. And we go way back many, many, many years. I remember him... I think when I was in Form 5, you were in Form something. Like Form 1, Form 2. But we thank God for how far he has brought us and brought our past to cross. Hallelujah. Amen. And we work together. He's helping me. He's actually my engineer. He's helping me to build my church at Tikrom in Kumasi. And I'm sure very soon when we finish, you come and see what your pastor has built for us in Kumasi. You have a powerful pastor, I tell you. Yeah. So sometimes I'll be calling him in the night different times. When I don't get him, I'll pass through the wife. Then she will give me a back pass, you know. But I think that God has been so good to us. And today, he also is a convener of the Anakazo Assemblies denomination. It shows the faithfulness of God. And we are so humbled by what the Lord has done in our lives. Bishop Jude, God bless you. God bless you. I see a beautiful work that is going on here. As I saw the choir standing here singing, I said, wow, somebody must be working here. And we thank God. God bless you. And of course, his beautiful wife, Lady Pastor Gifty. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. For always being there. She's always smiling. You never see her. I don't know, Bishop Jude, does he ever get angry or something? That one is another issue. But as far as I'm concerned, she's always smiling. And it's a joy to be around her. She exudes so much virtue, beautiful virtue that comes out of her. So we thank God for her life. Amen. And of course, we can't say all this without giving thanks to our father, Bishop Dag Heward Mills. Hallelujah. Who has given us this opportunity. Hey. Pastor Ben, I tell you, it's just the grace of God. Today as I was watching him ministering in Pennsylvania, awesome, awesome. It was just something else. The anointing. Hey, too much, too much, too much. God has been good. We also want to salute Bishop Intefo. Hey! I was just talking to him a few minutes ago before coming. And he asked, are you around? I said, I'm around. I said, I'm just on my way. He said, okay. So I believe that his spirit is also here with us. The spirit of our Father is here with us. And I know we're going to have a blessed time these 3 nights. Well, tonight, if you are ready as I am, just lift up your hands to the Lord. Oh yes, thank you, Lord Jesus. Ora bashanta da basanda da bane. Oh yes. Come, Holy Spirit, I need you. Come, sweet Spirit, we pray. Spirit, we need you. Come, sweet Spirit, we pray. Come in your strength and in your power. Come in your own special way. Holy Spirit, do what you do best. As we have gathered in these 3 nights, let lives be touched. Let lives be transformed. Let destinies be changed. Let there be miracles in our midst. Let there be healings in our midst. Let anyone who came here confused receive direction in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the discouraged be encouraged in the name of Jesus. We bind every work of the devil. We come against every plan of Satan. We cancel every work of the enemy in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, let your perfect plan and your will for our lives be done. We thank you that this church will never be the same again. We worship you. In Jesus' name we pray. Somebody shouted amen. Hallelujah. God bless you. Please be seated in the presence of the Lord. Wow, I feel very far away, so I want to come closer. Can I come closer? I can come closer? Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. We thank God. Well, in these 3 nights, our Holy Ghost convention, I'm going to be sharing with you from our Father's book, Flow in the Anointing. Flow in the Anointing. Hallelujah. And I believe that already God has started some beautiful things in our lives. This month of July is the 7th month, isn't it? 7 is the number of perfection. So I believe that God is perfecting things in your life. The Bible says that God shall perfect all that concerns you. And I prophesy over you that God is going to perfect everything that concerns you. Whatever has been a concern, whatever has been a problem that you have had sleepless night. I'm from Osekrom, so may God perfect it in your life. May God change every situation. Your finances, your business, it is changing. God is perfecting it. He's making it perfect in your life. Receive it in the name of Jesus. So God is going to do it for us. And one of the ways that God works in our lives is through His Spirit. We must be conscious of the supernatural in our lives. We must be conscious of the workings of the Holy Spirit. Because basically our whole lives is really determined by the Spirit of God. Whatever you see happening in the natural has already taken place in the Spirit. And we must learn to operate in the Spirit. Actually, we are more of spirit than flesh. Yeah. It is the fall of man that has made us become more fleshy than spiritual. But we are actually supposed to be more spiritual than fleshy. It's sad. But I believe that conventions like these are taking us back to that place where we can have sweet fellowship with God. Hallelujah. You know, when you read the Bible in Acts chapter 17, if you can turn to Acts chapter 17, and I think I'll read from verse 24. Now, this was when Paul had gone to this city and found them worshipping it. They had this altar, they had written on it to the unknown God. I mean, they were worshipping a God that they didn't know, you know. And when you don't have any relationship with the Holy Spirit, certainly you will not know God. He is the one who leads us to God. He shows us God. And the Bible says that God that made the world, so he was telling them, he said, God that made the world and all things therein, seeing that he is Lord of heaven and earth, and dwelleth not in temples made with hands. So we need to get to the point that God is not that type of person that we can see around. He doesn't dwell in the temples and all that. He's a spirit. Bible says God is a spirit. They that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth. So he says that neither is he worshipped with men's hands as though he needed anything. God doesn't need anything. He is God all by himself. Like the songwriter, you are God alone. Before time began, you are on your throne. You are God alone. And right now, and then, you are. He's God all by himself. He doesn't need anything. In fact, rather, the Bible says that he is the one who gives to all life, breath, and all things. May you receive life. May you receive breath. May you receive all things. I don't know what I'm prophesying to somebody. May you receive life. May you receive breath. May you receive all things. All things means all things. That means your car that you're going to drive. May God give it to you. Your wife you are looking for. Your husband you are looking for. Your job you are looking for. May God give it to you. Receive it. Don't let the person sitting by you intimidate you. Because there are some people, they are slow to react. They take a long time. No, one time I was in a service and the man of God was praying and he said, anybody believing God for a child, you should come or something. And there was a lady who was also in the service. She was also believing God for a child and I knew her. But she didn't move. She was just there. And then somebody from the back ran. Bishop, he ran and came, and a man of God laid hands on her. Can you believe exactly 9 months or a year after, that lady gave birth to twins? Yes. And this lady said to me later, that do you know that? When the woman went, I should have gone. I didn't go. And I saw that God had blessed her with a baby. So sometimes there are some people, they are slow to react. We call them old Solomon. Old Solomon. But there are some young Solomon. When it comes to receiving your blessing, when it comes to receiving your anointing, you will not allow the person sitting by you jump to your feet. Give the Lord a shout. Hey! Ask your neighbor, are you an old Solomon or a young Solomon? I see God giving you life. I see God giving you breath. I see God giving you all things. In the name of Jesus. Sit down before you begin to fly. And has made of one blood all nations of men for to dwell on the face of the earth. And has determined the times before appointed and the bounds of their habitation. Verse 27. That, look at that. They should seek the Lord. That is the main thing, that we must seek the Lord. Some of you are seeking all sorts of things. I don't know. I don't know what you are seeking for. You've been moving up and down, to and fro, seeking something. I don't know what you are seeking for. But the Bible says that you will seek for the Lord. You see, the Bible says that he has placed you somewhere. He has determined the bounds of your habitation. All these things, it was not for nothing. Your being in Ghana, it's not by chance. Go back to verse 26. Yeah, look at it. He said he has made one blood all nations of men to dwell on the face of it, and has determined the times appointed and the bounds of their habitation. So where you are supposed to inhabit, God has determined it. Even you being in the Abeka church, God determined that you should be here for a reason. Oh yes. He has determined it way before you came. So he said, so that, verse 27, you will seek the Lord. You will seek the Lord. Sometimes some of the problems you are going through, it is meant for you to seek the Lord. It is meant for you to look for God. Sometimes you see some people that rather go away from God. But those things are meant for you to look for God. He said, if happily they might feel after him. So God is somebody you must feel. You must feel God. But there are sometimes when people come to church, we don't feel anything. Just like you are like wawa board or doom tree. Nothing moves you. When I say, I feel the Holy Ghost moving, sir. Yeah, I don't feel anything. I'm rather feeling like poo poo. Feeling in him. But from tonight, I see people with feelings. May you feel after God. There's feeling. There must be feeling. Oh, serving God, there must be feeling the thing. Oh, yes. Feeling. No. That they might feel after him. And what? Find him, though he be not far from everyone of us. God is not far away. It's because you are not seeking for him. That's why. But if you seek for God, you will find him. I said, if you seek for God, and I believe in these 3 nights, somebody is going to find God. Oh, only 5 people respond. I said, somebody is going to find God. You will live here knowing that you have found God. You have met God. You have had an encounter with God. That is going to be your portion. Have you started feeling something at all? Somebody is still wondering. Oh Solomon don't have feelings. You're moistic. Verse 28. For in him we live and move. I see you living and I see you moving. Oh, they thought you were going to stay at that place forever. I see you moving. You are moving from being just an ordinary church member to becoming a shepherd. You are moving from being a shepherd to become a pastor. You are moving from being a pastor to become a reverend minister. Am I prophesying to somebody? That will be your testimony. You are moving from that one bedroom house. That house, 10 people use one toilet. From tonight, I said from tonight, I see you moving. Say, I'm moving. You will not stay at that place forever. You are moving. Him we live and move and have our being. In him, once you are in him, you cannot stay at one place. That is why we need to be in him, to be connected to him, to be connected to the anointing, to be connected to the power of the Holy Spirit. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. There is nobody connected to the Holy Spirit who stays at one place. No. You always move. The Holy Spirit is a mover. It's a mover. Yeah. That is how our church has been moving. We have not been at one place. We have moved, and we are still moving. And there are many more things to come. The Lord has not finished with the UD, the First Love Church. The Lord has not finished with us at all. So if you thought that the Lord has finished, then you are mistaken. There is more in the Holy Ghost. Yeah, he's a mover. Bible says that when God created the heavens and the earth, and the earth was without form and void and darkness upon the face of the deep, the Bible says that, and the Holy Spirit moved. He moved on the surface of the waters. There was a movement. Yeah. Yeah. That's why when we look at you and your life is still at one place, we cannot understand. Maybe you are not connected properly. But from tonight, you are connecting. God said, let there be light. And it was happening. So we need to understand who the Holy Spirit is and how he even represents himself in our midst. That way we can receive all that he has for us. Yeah. Once you have that understanding. Yeah. And one of the things you need to understand is that the Holy Spirit is a person. He's a person. In the same way you relate to your friend, you can relate to the Holy Spirit in the same way. Benny Hinn wrote a book many years ago, Good Morning, Holy Spirit. I mean, he believed that when he wakes up in the morning, just as he says good morning to his friends, he should be able to say good morning to the Holy Spirit. That is where it begins from. That you can discuss things with the Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, what do you think? Because his work is to help you. He's a helper. He's a helper. John 14, 16. Can you give me that scripture? Are you there? Oh, I feel it. He said what? And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter. Now, when you open up the comforter in the Amplified Bible, it gives you many things. You have Amplified Bible, the Amplified Classified. Yeah. Do you have that? But you see that the comforter is open up. And he is many things to you. Once you begin to know him, you enjoy him. Yeah. But in chapter 16, but when you look at the Amplified, it says he's a comforter, he's a standby, he's an advocate, he's an intercessor, he's a strengthener, all that. You should find Amplified on your this day, not NLT, Amplified. Yeah. Okay, so try and get it if you don't have it. But in chapter 16, look at chapter 16 and verse 13, John 16, 13, he says that, how be it when he, the Spirit of truth, so you can see that he is referring to him as a person. When he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you. He will guide you. So he has a work of guiding you. If you allow him, you will not make all the mistakes you have been making. Yeah. Some people, when they see a girl with the somebody says Stanchart and Barclays. I mean, that is what you are led by. But when the Holy Spirit is there, he will guide you. You will not make a mistake. He will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak. And he will show you things to come. Yeah. We must have a beautiful fellowship with the Holy Spirit. And I'm telling you, your life is going to be far better than what it is. God wants you to enjoy a very good life. Oh, did you hear me? God wants you to enjoy a good life. And from tonight, a good life has started with you. And I'm showing you the person who will give you the good life. He's called the Holy Ghost. He's called the Holy Spirit. From tonight, may you begin to walk with him. May you include him in your life. May you call him every time. Every morning when you wake up, involve him in whatever you are doing. He's going to help you to have a good life in the name of Jesus. Tell three people, involve the Holy Spirit. Oh, Jesus. Now, one of the reasons why we are not able to involve him or make him a part of our lives is because we don't know how to flow with him. We don't understand his ways. We don't know how he operates. But thank God the Bible has given us different ways by which the Holy Spirit is represented. Yeah. So once you understand the ways that he's represented, you'll be able to flow with him. Yeah. If you're a wife, you must understand the kind of husband you are married to. No, all men are not the same. There are some people, when they come home and their food is not ready, they don't mind. You don't mind. Yeah. But there are some people, when they arrive, the food must be ready. The fufu. And you offend that you do fear now. So kochi akukono wo baby nwe kum akukono. And sana one near akukono. Before you realize you are losing your marriage. So you must understand the man you are married to. Yeah. And men also understand the women you are married to. Oh, yes. Yeah. Because everybody's love language is different. There are some people, they like you to sit in the kitchen with them. Hey! As they are cooking, you are sitting there. Yeah. There are some people, too, they always want to you take them out. Hey! So you need to understand who you are dealing with. When you understand, you can flow. So, one of the ways the Holy Spirit is represented is that he is represented as water. Wow. Water. 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 So, straight away, a whole lot of things begin to come to your mind. If the Holy Spirit is like water, then what are some of the things I can do with water? Yeah. You can drink when you are thirsty. So that's how we can say we are drinking of the Holy Ghost. So the word is saying, what are these people talking about? Because you have not understood that the Holy Ghost can be represented as water. And it gives you an indication of satisfaction. Because once the Holy Spirit comes, you'll be satisfied. Your thirst will be quenched. Earthly things have left me dry. Only you can satisfy. So the Bible says in Isaiah 44, look at that. Beautiful. Verse 3. Isaiah 44, verse 3. 44. Are you there? He said, for I will pour water upon him that is thirsty. Wow. So you are wondering, what are they talking about? What water is God talking about? He said, I'm going to pour water on him that is thirsty. And floods upon the dry ground. Tonight, anybody who is thirsty, anybody who feels dry, may the waters of the Spirit be poured upon you in the name of Jesus. He said, I will pour waters and floods upon the dry ground. And then he puts a colon. When you read the Bible, you need to look out for some of these things. A colon means that I'm explaining what I've just said. Kalabosha. Maybe I should go to... should I go to cantonments and preach? I should be here. I'll be here. So, he's explaining, and the explanation for this water is that I will pour my spirit upon thy seed and my blessing. Tonight, may the Lord pour his spirit upon you. May the Lord pour his blessings upon you. Receive the Spirit of the Lord. Receive an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Receive the blessing of the Lord upon your life. In the name of Jesus. I will pour my spirit. I will pour my spirit. I will pour my spirit upon him that is thirsty. Oh, I see somebody, you have been thirsty for the past 2 weeks. You have had a thirst for God. You have been thirsty for God. You have been looking forward for this time. You came to the convention that, Lord, I will find you, that I will have an encounter with you. I see the Lord pouring his spirit upon you. I see the Lord touching you tonight. I see an outpouring of the Holy Spirit coming upon you in the name of Jesus. Something is happening already. I see people who are thirsty. The psalmist said in Psalm 41, he said, as the deer pants for the water brooks, he said, so my soul longeth for thee. I don't know whether there are people here who are thirsty. Psalm 41, put that scripture there. As the deer pants after the water brooks. Tonight, may you be like a deer panting after the water brooks. So my soul panted after thee, O God. Why are you panting for God? This is somebody who understands that the Holy Ghost is like water. I can thirst for the water. I can pant for the water. I can look for the water. Anytime it is said that anytime the deer is being chased by a lion or whatever, the nearest thing it is looking for is water. Looking for water. Because it knows that once it finds water, all the problems will be solved. He's going to hide there. He's going to vanish there. He's going to... Tonight, may you find the water of the Spirit. As many as are thirsty for the water, may you find the waters of the Spirit. And may you find a hiding place in the name of Jesus. He said in verse 2, he said, look at that. I love it. My soul thirsteth for God, for the living God. He said, when shall I come and appear before God? When? But tonight you are here. Ha ha. Verse 3. He said, thank you, Holy Spirit. My tears have been my meat day and night. I don't know who has been here. You have been crying. But he said, they say continually to you, where is your God? People have been asking you. Now, you are always moving. We don't know what is happening. Where is your God? I prophesy over you that your God is going to come through for you. As the waters of the Spirit is poured upon you, may your God visit you. May your God come through for you. May your God do a work in your life. In the name of Jesus, I see a move of the Spirit of God. I see an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. Your God is coming through tonight. Receive the touch of the Lord. Makataba kushandaraba. Hey, Abro Sandaraba. As the deer panted for the water brooks,
so as the deer.
The people who are saying that, where is your God? After this convention, they are not going to say that again. When they say, where is your God? They would like to follow you to your church. Am I talking to somebody here? I see people following you to your church. Where is your God? Our God is alive. I see an outpouring of the Holy Spirit. I see people who are thirsty, looking for God, panting. You have come. When shall I appear before God? The Lord said, I should tell you, this is the time. You are finding God. Where is your God? Verse 4, he said, thank you, Holy Spirit. When I remember these things, I pour out my soul in me. For I had gone with the multitude. I went with them to the house of God with the voice of joy and praise, with the multitude that kept holy day. And verse 5 says, why are you cast down, O my soul? Adena wabemwe usa. Na bibi ye irade eye ne irade eye ne din so be ya na. Why are you disquieted? Hope in God. From tonight, a new hope. People who have given up, the Lord is giving you new hope. No more shall your soul be cast down. In Psalm 63, verse 1, look at that. Still the Holy Spirit is seen as water. He said, oh God, thou art my God. Early will I seek you. My soul thirsteth for thee. My flesh longeth for thee in a dry and a thirsty land where no water is. Anybody who is thirsty for God, may you have an experience tonight. Why is he thirsty? He said in verse 2, he said, to see your power and thy glory. Oh yes, I see a new breed of people who are operating by the power and the glory of God. Oh, la bashakata da branda randa bakusata da basa shikata badoko solaba. I see a people that are thirsty for God. I see a people that are thirsty for God. I see somebody, you have come here with a test for God, and I see you experiencing the power and the glory. Receive the power. Receive the glory. Receive the power. Receive the glory. Oh yes, to see your power and your glory in the sanctuary. In this sanctuary, you are going to see the power. You are going to see the glory. I see people experiencing the power of God and the glory of God. It is happening all over this place. May you see his power. Oh Jesus. That's it. Oh Jesus. Mashandarabana. Oh yes. Lord, I sense a power flowing. I sense a power flowing. I sense a power flowing. Oh, Jesus.
Thirst for you, and I long to be in your presence.
My soul
will wait on you.
Father, draw me nearer.
Father,
The story has changed from tonight. Loma Shakata Rabasana. A new story. A new story. Yeah. Thank you, Lord. When the Holy Spirit comes as water, you will be satisfied. Yeah. You will experience His power and His glory. Two powerful things are happening in your life. The power of God to deal with the works of the enemy, and the glory of God to make your life beautiful. Oh yes. Jesus, get me a bottle of water. Thank you, Lord. For I will pour water. For I will pour water. Jesus. Lift up your hand. Something is just happening. Receive it. That's it. Take it tonight. For I will pour water. Oh Jesus. That's it. Receive it. It's flowing. Ashes, watch them. Watch them. Watch them. Watch them. Watch them. Watch them. For I will pour water on him. Jesus. That's it. Ashes, watch them. Receive it. For I will pour water. Receive it. Jesus. Watch. Watch. Ashes, be alert. Be alert. For I will pour water on him that is thirsty. Jesus. Oh Lord. That's it. Look at this choristers. Something is happening. Choristers, receive it. Jesus. Hey. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. From tonight, may you experience the power and the glory of God. Watch it. Watch it. Watch it. Receive it. Now, it's flowing. It's flowing. It's flowing. It's flowing now. Look at these people. Receive the power and the glory. The power and the glory. The power to deal with situations in your life. And the glory to make your life beautiful. Somebody's life is becoming beautiful from tonight. Receive it. That's it. Watch it. Watch it. Watch it. Watch it. Watch it. Receive it. Hey! My soul abandoned. Bring it to me. Oh, yes. Something is happening. Receive it. It's flowing. It's flowing. It's flowing. Receive it. Jesus. Yes. 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 Somebody I just saw you, it's like you're feeling cold all of a sudden. Come to me right now. You're feeling, you all of a sudden started feeling cold. Come to me. That is the Holy Ghost. He just touched you. Come. Oh Jesus, please find something to wipe these things. Oh yes. That's the Holy Spirit. Yes. 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 Oh Jesus. That's it. Experiencing the power and the glory. The power and the glory. The power and the glory. Oh, yes. That is why Isaiah asked the question, Isaiah 55, verse 1. He said, who? Somebody say, who? Say, who? It's like, everyone that is thirsty, what is your problem? Who? Somebody say, who? You know how sometimes you see somebody say, hey, I have a problem, and you know the solution. Oh, oh. That's what Isaiah said. Oh, everyone that is thirsty, come to the waters. Come to the waters. Tonight, may you be at the waters to receive the touch of the Lord. Why have you wasted your time? He said, he who has no money. We are talking about something you don't need money for. When you begin to operate in the anointing, stop thinking about money. Stop thinking about money. And I'm talking to somebody here. You have been worried about money. I don't know who that person is. Come to me. You have been worried about money. The Lord says, stop worrying. Come. Come to me. You have worried about money. I don't know. Tonight, I'm just moving as the Spirit leads me. We are having a Holy Ghost convention. He who has no money, come buy it. Yea, come buy wine. Milk without money, without price. Are there anyone missing a summer house? Come to the waters. Come to the waters. Say the Spirit of the Lord. Lift up your hand. Come to the waters. Tonight, you have come to the waters. Jesus. Receive more than you can carry. Yay. Jesus. Yes. 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 Jesus. Receive it. From tonight, money will not be a problem for you. Just seek for him. Come to the waters. Come to the waters. Seek for the Spirit of God. Oh, why are you worried about money? No, 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 no. Money should never be your worry after today. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. For they that put their trust in him. Oh Jesus. Shall never be put to shame. You will not be put to shame. In the name of Jesus. Yes. Yes.
He said, wherefore do you spend money for that which is not bread? And you labor for that which satisfies not. Hearken diligently unto me, and eat ye that which is good, and let your soul delight itself. Oh, look at that. Somebody is delighting yourself in the Lord. As I watch, you see some people laughing in the Holy Ghost. They are just delighting themselves in the Lord. Carry them to me. You will see people laughing in the Holy Spirit because the Holy Ghost is just putting some joy in you. That which has been a great concern from today to not be a concern. Delight yourself. And you see, the Holy Spirit can move on from just as water that you're experiencing. And he moves to the level of rain. Now he comes on you. Watch. He comes on you. You see, somebody's watching. Said, what is happening? You see, you don't even feel anything. In Hosea chapter 6, verse 1, he said, come, let us return unto the Lord. For he has torn and he will heal us. Tonight, healing is coming. Somebody is being healed tonight. He has smitten. He will bind us. Verse 2, he said, after 2 days, he will revive us. I prophesy, by tomorrow night, there shall be a revival in this place. I see a revival. I see a revival. A revival in your prayer life. A revival in your walk with God. A revival in every area of your life. And in the third day, he will raise us up. By the end of the third day, I see you being raised up. If you were down, I see you coming up. Promotion will be your portion. He said, verse 3, then we shall know if we follow on to know the Lord. He said, his going forth is prepared as the morning, and he shall come unto us as the rain. As the rain. Sometimes you can be in the service and you can literally feel like rain is falling. Healing rain, miracle rain, rain of blessing. Somebody's receiving rain. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Rain. Rain. Jesus. Oh, thank you, Lord. Bring this lady to me. Come to me. In Ezekiel 34. Thank you. will be their God. And my servant David, a prince among them. I, the Lord, have spoken it. Verse 25. And I will make with them a covenant of peace. And I will cause the evil beast to cease out of the land. Verse 26. Look at it. And I will make them and the places round about my hill a blessing. From tonight, God is making you a blessing. How is he going to do that? And I will cause the shower to come down in his season. The shower. There shall be showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. Showers of blessing. Receive it. Watch them. There shall be showers. Watch them. It's breaking forth all over this place. Showers of blessing. In seasons, just like rain. So you need to understand that there is a season which is your season, and I believe that Abeka Church, this is your season. And I'm speaking to somebody in particular. This is your season. Whatever should have been your portion, that has never happened. This is your season. This is your season. Oh, yeah. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. It's happening. I see no less than 7 people. The Holy Ghost is saying, this is your season. I just want them and carry them to me. One, that's it. Two, three, four, five, yes, six, seven. Bring them. It's time to shine again.
Time to shine again. Oh, in a world.
there's always something that is given to you from heaven. I don't know, but I feel something you need is being given to you from heaven. Watch them. People are receiving things from heaven. This one is not man giving to you. Heaven is giving to you. Heaven. Watch them. They are receiving it. They are receiving it. And bring them to me. They are receiving it. You are receiving something that is given to you from heaven. I like it. Except it be given to you from heaven. From today, we are not looking to man. We are looking to heaven. So now, lift up your hand and say, Lord, I receive something from heaven. Something from heaven. Watch them. Heaven is releasing things to people right now. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Something from heaven. Bring them to me. The Lord himself is giving you things from heaven. Oh Jesus. Oh Jesus.
Be satisfied.
Something from heaven.
Receive.
Receive something from heaven. For your ministry is given to you now. Take it one. Take it two. Take it three. Receive it now. Receive it. Receive it. Receive it. Yes. Let me pray for the pastors who are there. Something from heaven. Something from heaven. Lift up your hands. God, a gift of working of miracles, a gift of healing, an apostolic gift. Oh Jesus, something is happening. Something that only heaven can give to you tonight. Receive it. The Holy Ghost is telling me something that only heaven, only heaven, only heaven, only heaven, only heaven can give to you.
Receive it.
Open up the sky.
lift up your hand. Something is being given to you from heaven. 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 Receive a gift from heaven. Issued from under the threshold of the house. Waters. And the waters came down from under, from right side of the house to the south side of the altar. Many times when we come into the presence of the Lord, waters. Waters are gushing out. Waters are gushing out. May you receive the waters of the Spirit. Waters. You may not know, but there's like a river flowing. Flowing. He said in Revelation 22, I'll come to this scripture, but Holy Ghost is drawing my mind to something. Revelation 22, verse 1. Look at it. I'll come to Ezekiel. And he showed me a pure river of water of life, clear as crystal. Where is it coming from? Proceeding out of the throne of God. Proceeding. So when we gather that out of the presence, where there's water gushing. Tonight, I see a pure river of life proceeding from the throne of God and coming to you. Jesus. Water is flowing. He said, the water is flowing, verse 2, on every side in the midst of the street of it, every side of the river was there a tree of life which bare 12 manner of fruits. And yielded her fruit every month. And the leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. Every month there's a fruit that must come into your life. When these waters, when the river is flowing, I prophesy from July, August, September, I don't know who, somebody's receiving October. The river is flowing. It's flowing. November, the river is flowing. Every month, may you receive the fruits that must come to you. As a church, may we receive the fruits. May we receive the fruits. May we walk in the fruits. May there be healing for the nations. That is why you must go deep.
Draw me deeper. Look deeper.
Ezekiel 47, I'm closing, but something keeps pulling me back. Ezekiel 47 verse 2, he said, then he brought me out to the way, gate northward, and led me about the way without the water. Verse 3, look at that. And when the man had the line in his hand measured, he said, he brought me to the waters, and they were to my anchors. Many of us, the waters, we have only come to the anchor level. Just 10% of your life is in the spiritual. 90% of your life is too carnal. These things we are talking about, you will experience them. You will wonder, how can some people talk about all these things? Because wabra bono eye hunam no boss or say hunum no. What did the American answer? Why we TV sa kum kum bajia? Ayawum ashawuma. You are listening to radio. This, that, no spirit.
Lord, deeper into your world of truth.
Oh, yes.
Draw me deeper, Lord, deeper into your love.
Full of the Holy Spirit. Ask the Holy Spirit to fill you. Choristers. Ask the Holy Spirit to fill you. Yes, tell the Lord, draw me deeper. I want to go deeper. I want to go deeper. I want to go deeper. And watch the waters are coming up. The waters are coming up. Oh yes. Some of you can feel as if you are swimming. You can feel the current carrying you. That's it. Some of you can feel that you can't feel your legs. It's as if something is carrying you. That is it. You are coming deep into the waters. Deep into the waters. Jesus. Watch them.
Just hold me.
I see people who are being drawn by the Spirit. Jesus. Yes. 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 People who are being drawn by the Spirit. From today, there'll be a drawing. Jesus said, no man can come to me except the Father draws him. I see a drawing. People are being drawn. Watch them. You are being drawn. You are being drawn. You are being drawn. Deeper in love. You are being drawn. Jesus. 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 I see people being drawn. And I see a lot of young people. I see many young people. Oh, Jesus. I see many young people between the ages of 20 and 30 being drawn, being drawn, being drawn. Yes, Jesus, Jesus, they are being drawn. Oh, thank you, Lord Jesus. Young people between 20 and 30, there is a drawing. I see people being drawn. God is going to use you. Jesus, 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 Jesus. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. People between 20 and 30, God is going to use you. Oh, look at that. Jesus. Jesus. Oh, look at that. The glory is so great, they cannot even stand. That is what the Bible calls the weight of glory. Glory has weight. Yes. When it hits you, you cannot even stand. Oh, Jesus. Yes. Watch them. Watch them. Many young people, the Lord is calling you. Yes. 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 Oh, yes. Thank you, Lord. Oh, Father, we bless you. What's happening there? Many young people. I see many young people. Everybody stand to your feet as we close. That the Lord is calling. Father, touch the young ones. Oh, thank you, Holy Spirit. When the river flows, there is a refreshing. I see people experiencing times of refreshing. May you be refreshed. Be refreshed tonight. Be refreshed tonight. Watch them. Wherever there has been weakness and tiredness, I hear somebody say, I am tired. 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 Bring them to me. I am tired. Refresh. 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 Hey! Times of refreshing. Look at that. Times of refreshing. Receive it. Receive it. You have been refreshed tonight. New strength, new zeal, new hope. Receive it. You almost gave up. You said, I cannot go on again. You said, I'm tired. You are the very person that the river is hitting now. Receive it. I see somebody with a difficulty in breathing. The river is flowing your way right now. Receive healing now. It's flowing. Receive healing. Wherever the river flows, healing flows. Tonight, wherever you are not well, place your hand there. The healing power of God is touching you now. I sense healing rain is falling. Healing rain is falling. Healing rain is falling. The river is flowing. Wherever you are, the rain is bringing about a river. Receive it. Receive it. Ear problems are being healed now. Yes, receive it in the name of Jesus. Stomach ache. Receive healing now in Jesus' name. Backache. Be healed. Be delivered. Every power of infirmity is broken over your life in Jesus' name. Yes. Pain in the legs, receive your healing. It's gone from tonight. It's gone from tonight. Asthma, loose now in Jesus' name. Ulcer, loose now in Jesus' name. Right now, be loose from every pain. Be loose from every infirmity. In the name of Jesus Christ, the Lord is healing you now. Receive healing from the crown of your head to the soles of your feet. The Lord is touching you. That growth in your body is leaving you now. Loose in Jesus' name. The lump in your breast is going now in Jesus' name. The healing rain and the river of healing is flowing your way. It's flowing your way. It's flowing your way. Take it, receive it. In the name of Jesus, that headache is gone. That pain. Somebody's been healed of a toothache. It's gone from today in Jesus' name. The dizzy spells you have been having from tonight is over. Father, thank you for your healing, for your deliverance. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
The healing rain is falling down.
The healing rain
is falling down. I'm not afraid.
Somebody invited you to church, but you are not born again. You don't know Jesus as Lord and Savior. You cannot have a relationship with the Holy Spirit if you are not born again. And you cannot make it to heaven. Today, as every head is bowed, all eyes closed, you want to surrender your life to Jesus. You want to be born again. Tonight, if you are here, just lift up your right hand. You want to say, Pastor, pray with me. I need Jesus. Can we all stand to our feet? We are closing. I want to surrender my life to Jesus. Lift up your right hand. I'm going to pray with you. Tonight is a night of salvation. God bless you. I see your hand. Let it go up above your head. Don't be shy. Don't be shy. Lift up your hand. You want to give your life to Jesus. Let it go up above your head. Let it go up above your head. Don't put it down. Let it go up above your head. God bless you. Let it go up. Let it go up. Tonight is a night of salvation. God bless you. You need Jesus in your life. Let it go up. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. If you have lifted up your hand, do one more thing for me. Still with your hand lifted, move out of your seat and come to me right now.
Heaven, come. Heaven,
come. Come, let me pray.
Come on to Jesus. Come on to Jesus.
God bless you.
Come. Give him your love.
Come.
Give him.
Healings have taken place already tonight. Tonight, you came here with a sickness, some pain or something, but somehow, as we pray, it's gone. The power of God touching is gone. Give me a wave of your hand. You check yourself. God bless you. It's gone. The Lord healed you. Lift up your hand. The Lord healed you of something. Lift it up. God bless you. God bless you. Check yourself. You can see it's gone. The Lord has touched you and healed you. Let me see, by wave of your hand. Somebody, the pain in their chest, it went. God bless you. God bless you. Lift it up. God bless you. God bless you. Oh, keep it up. Don't put it down. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep it up. Keep it up. I see many hands lifted. God bless you. God bless you. Those of you with your hands lifted, can you come to me right now? Come to me. Come to me. Come to my right hand side. If the Lord has touched you in any way, come quickly. Clap for them. Clap for them as they come. You came with a sickness. You came with something that is gone. Come this way. Keep clapping. Keep clapping. Oh, yes.
And all the joy.
Those of you who aren't here, Pastor Gabriel, let's find out what is happening here. Okay. Those of you who aren't here, lift up your two hands. It's a sign of surrender. And I want us all to pray together with them. Oh, can we stand to our feet? We are praying. This is a very important time. Pray after me. Say, Lord Jesus, tonight I thank you for dying on the cross to save me from my sins. Please forgive me all my sins. Come into my heart. Make me a new person. Please write my name in the Lamb's Book of Life. From today, I will serve you. I will follow you for the rest of my days. Thank you, Jesus, for saving me. Amen. Wow. God bless you. What's your name? Sarah. And you are? Priscilla. Collins. Lord. Wow. Juliet. Your names have been written down in the book of life. Wow. God bless you. Look at our pastor standing here. Waving his hand. He's going to talk to you for 3 minutes, okay? Then you come back and join us, okay?
Bishop, tonight the Lord is healing chest pains.
The Lord is doing what?
Healing chest pains.
Chest pains, because I saw it.
Come. Yeah. Ebenezer here said this morning when he went to school, he started experiencing chest pains.
Chest pains.
Yeah. Especially when he's laughing.
When he's laughing. You see, sometimes you take a lot of things for granted. When you are there, you laugh. You see, you are laughing. But it's not easy for some people. When they laugh, is that how you are feeling? He's crying. Wow, tell me, what happened?
Usually, it's like something is pulling me.
Something is pulling you?
Yeah. So when I laugh a little bit, it's like an anchor from a ship on the ground. So it makes the ship not move. That's how it's affecting my heart.
No, the guy is describing what he's going through. It's like an anchor from a ship. Hey, how do you know? Have you been on a ship before? But you can feel like it. So now you can laugh. And you don't feel any pain. Oh, put your hands together for Jesus. Wow. Like an anchor. And you feel the pain. But right now it's gone. Oh. Somebody put your hands together for Jesus. Father, thank you. But why would these children come and lie to us? I don't think so. What happened to Solomon?
Chest pain.
Also chest pain. Hey, how long has he been here? Are your parents here? He was breathless. Give him the microphone.
Yes. So, Bishop, what
where
it is
my photographer? Are you the one? Are you the one? Sadia, hello. In Kofor chapter Simone, now you know. You have to take a picture. Take a picture. That's how you do it. The other one, did you take it? You didn't take it. You were somewhere. Wow, the boy came with the anchor in the chest. Hey, understand it. Where were you when he was describing the uncle? Look at that. So you didn't know that you had to take a picture. He knew. You are forgiven. He was listening to the message. What's your name?
Solomon.
So that's your dad.
Yes.
What happened?
So Bishop, what it is that Sunday because of him, my wife couldn't come to church because I left early to come, and then I was called that he couldn't breathe and he was feeling pains around the chest.
Wow.
So yesterday in the morning it was very severe, very severe. So we have to rush him to the hospital for some injections and scans and a whole lot of stuff. Yes, and then so as I was coming, because of him, I told my wife that they should watch online. But he insisted that he wants to come.
Come on.
Daddy, I want to come. Mommy, I want to come. So let's all come. And then whilst you were praying for us, I went to the back and I realized that one hand was up and then the other was on the chest.
Mm.
Yes, and then I just, when you call for the testimonies, I just saw him coming
in to the front.
I think it's
said. I felt the Lord healing chest, something about the chest. And now it's gone. You don't feel anything again. So what couldn't he do? He couldn't breathe or what?
Couldn't breathe. Yes. And you could see that he's really, yesterday in the morning, he was really struggling to breathe.
Wow.
Struggling, yes.
Solomon, breathe in. You don't feel anything. Oh, put your hands together for Jesus. Father, thank you. Jesus, amen.
Same chest pain.
Chest pain. Tonight the Lord has just visited the chest department. How long has it been there? What was the problem? What's the name?
Gifty.
Yes. How long has this problem been?
For a long time.
About 5 years.
More than that.
Hey.
Yes.
Wow.
It's on and off.
On and off. So what has been happening to you?
Okay, this one, a brother that is disturbing me in the house, last week he came there and then started rubbing his hand at my back. So I started feeling some pains within me.
What kind of brother is that? What kind of disturbance?
He's troublesome, please.
The brother is troublesome.
Yes, very, very troublesome.
Why? He says he likes you or what? Is that what he's saying? You don't know. But he was rubbing his hand on your back.
Yes.
Hey.
Last 2 weeks, Saturday, he came to the house to fight me, but by the grace of God, I wasn't in the house. So he came again, and then I was sitting there. He came and greets me. So I was sitting there, and he started rubbing his hand at my back like this. I started feeling some pains in my chest. So I started rejecting it in my head. And then he went away. Yes. Yeah,
hey.
So when we were praying, physically.
So the brother was rubbing his hand at your back?
Yes.
But you should have run away or you were here. Yes.
I was
you were enjoying it or what? No. So that rubbing made you feel pain?
Yes, please. Yes,
wow.
Hey, another rubbing.
Yeah. Hey. They are rubbings and they are rubbing, so. But now the pain is gone.
Yes, please.
Oh, put your hands together for Jesus. Father, we thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Christopher
father,
here.
You shouldn't rub your back again. Good.
Another healing for chest pain.
Another chest pain. Hey, tell us what happened.
Almost 2 weeks now. I was having like a severe chest pain. Yes. And now, like,
you don't feel the pain anymore.
No, No, I've checked everything.
You have checked everything, then. Wow. What's your name?
Christopher.
Christopher. Father, thank you for Christopher. Thank you for healing. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, what happened here?
Ulcer, Emmanuel.
Ulcer. How do you know you are healed?
I was at the back there, I feel it.
You felt it?
Yeah.
And you know it's gone?
Yeah.
Hey, how do we check, doctors, how do you check if ulcer is gone?
Endoscopy.
Dr. Ben, are you sure? Can't get with hot pepper. You have to go and do what? Endoscopy. But the man says he's healed. So is there something that you were feeling, now you don't feel it? What was it? There was something that you were feeling pain, and now you don't feel the pain. Wow. Father, thank you for your healing in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Hey, ulcer, chest pain.
Headache.
Headache, how long have you had it?
Today.
Just today, came with a headache, and the Lord has healed you. Father, thank you for your healing. In Jesus' name, amen.
Yeah, Elizabeth, healing in the ear.
In the ear? Wow, that's a powerful one. How long have you had this?
2 years now.
2 years?
Yeah, I've been to hospital for now.
So what is it that you can't hear properly in that ear or what? So how do you know you are healed?
I feel the touch as I put my ears.
Can you?
As I put my hands on my ears, I feel the touch, so I've been healed. Yes.
So now this ear, you couldn't hear properly there.
Even the two.
Hey, wow. So when we're preaching, you couldn't hear.
I'm hearing, but within me, I feel like something is in my ears.
Wow. So how? I'm just trying to see how we can test this thing to see. So, if somebody was standing somewhere and was talking to you, you would hear.
That one there I can hear. But within me, like something is inside my ear.
Something is in the ear. You can feel like something is blocked in the ear, but now it's gone. Wow. Both ears. Father, thank you for healing the ears. We give you glory in Jesus' name. Amen. Put your hands together. Give me an offering bag. We are closing. This one is what I call victory offering. I want everybody to take out an offering, 50 Ghana cedis. I feel a special offering for 50 Ghana. Father, bless your people tonight as we give in Jesus' name. Amen. Run to the front, bring your 50 Ghana cedis. Come and sow. Come and give to the Lord. God bless you. God bless you. If you are giving by Momo, just bring your phone and come and touch. The number is there on the screen. God bless you. 50 Ghana cedis. God bless you. You took an envelope, but still you can give 50 Ghana. Come and give to the Lord. God bless you. 50 Ghana cedis. God bless you. 50 Ghana cedis. Let's close. 50 Ghana cedis. Bishop, God bless you. 50 Ghana cedis. Come all the way. 50 Ghana cedis. 50 Ghana cedis. 50. 50 Ghana. God bless you. God bless you. God bless you. 50 Ghana. You don't have 50, but you have 40 or 30 or 20. Rise up and come. 40 or 30 or 20. Come and give to the Lord. God bless you. You may be giving 40, 20 now, but I'm telling you, very soon you'll be giving 100 cedis and 200 cedis. 40, 30, 20. Come and give to the Lord. 40.
You are
40, 30, 20. Come and give to the Lord.
You are
God bless you. 10 cities also rise up and come. 10 Ghana cities.
And right now,
10 Ghana cities.
In the good times and bad.
God bless you. 10 Ghana cities.
You are on your throne.
10 Ghana cities. God bless you.
You are God alone. You are God alone. From before time began. You are on your throne. You are God alone. Right now, right now, in the good times and bad, you are on your throne.
unstoppable, unstoppable. That's who you are. Unchangeable, unchangeable, unshakable, unshakable, unstoppable, unstoppable. That's who you are. You are God. You are God alone.
From before time begins, you are on your throne.
You are God alone.
And right now,
listen, I just said that some of you are saying, Bishop, you gave the envelopes up to 100. You didn't give. So some of us would like to give 50 or 40 or 20. Come and take an envelope. Come on. Because I heard you saying it. Come and take an envelope. Bishop, you gave the envelope up to 100. Come. God bless you. Tomorrow or Friday, right? Hey, my dear, God bless you. May you become a school prefect one. Now we are ready. Powerful. Are you ready for tomorrow night and for Friday night? Hey, by Friday there you'll be flying. You'll be flying. Wonderful. We are blessed. God bless you. And tomorrow let's come early so we can close early. Let's welcome Bishop Jude. Oh, rock.
Yeah. Selman is a soa.
Hallelujah. Oh, you can do better. You can do better. Hallelujah. Okay, now. Everybody, take out your booster. You have not given booster. I have not forgotten your booster. Yes. Take out your booster. We are going to share the grace. When you put your booster inside, then you go home. If you don't put booster inside, don't go. Lift up your booster. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you. We bless you. Thank you for a powerful first night. May we be blessed as we give. In the name of Jesus. Amen. So come. Tomorrow, come early. Let's get
married. Take my yoke.